So what we can do if we want eyelids is first, we need to incorporate them into the rig in Photoshop. You can see right down here, we have those eyelids reserved. We set them aside just in case, but we can't actually put them into any group inside a character animator. We actually have to go through the process of Photoshop in order for this to work. So let's jump over here to Photoshop, and we are now back looking at this file. And I'm just going to come down here and find the eyelids. So we have front eyelids and then back eyelids. Let me just come over here and hide the glasses and then take these and bring them up so that I can see what's going on. So we're going to put them right now just into the head group so I can see this. Now I need to separate them all out. So if I come over here and hide this, we can see that we have the bottom and top eyelid for the front eye on this layer. I want to grab the selection tool, come in and just select the top eyelid, and then use Command X or Control X if you're on Windows, and then Command Shift V or Control Shift V if you're on Windows. And I'm just going to rename this one. Let me just look at my naming conventions here really quick. This one is top eyelid, and then hit enter. Come down here to the bottom, double click, and rename this one to bottom eyelid. Now we want to put these into the front eye group, which is the right eye for us. I'm just going to drop that down, and we're going to place both of those into that right eye group, and then we can collapse it. So now we want to do the same for the other layer. Just like that. So now all I'm going to do is drop down first left eye, and then we'll click on top eyelid, and we're just going to come in and click on the left eyelid top to assign it, and then come down here to your bottom eyelid and then bottom eyelid and assign, and then just go to your right eye and do the same for your top eyelid. Make sure you click on the right one, deselect the eye, and then for the bottom eyelid, you just want to make sure you click on the right area. Now, if I blink, you can see what it does, but also, if I try to move the eyes, I forgot it's linked to my mouse, you can see that the pupils react, but the eyelids, of course, will mask them out, essentially, if it goes up or down or whatever.
Full chapter 4 is linked below.